Hi friends, today I'm going to talk about Google BigQuery. Google BigQuery is an enterprise data warehouse. And Google BigQuery is a fully managed no operations data warehouse. Google BigQuery is a serverless and no need to instantiate an instance. What is the meaning that no need to instantiate an instance? For example, if I want to use the cloud SQL in the Google Cloud platform, I have to do some kind of a setup. Then only I can use the cloud SQL. The same way for Cloud Spanner also. So this kind of the preparation is not required while we are using the Google's BigQuery. That is the reason they are telling Google's BigQuery is a serverless and no need to instantiate an instance. Yes. And another option is, another feature is, Google's BigQuery enables extremely fast analytics on petabyte scale through its unique architecture and capability. Obviously, it's one kind of a OLAP tool. So that is the reason we can work on the petabytes of the data. Definitely, we'll go through that. What is that? If we want to access the Google's BigQuery, so we have three options. One is web UI, web user interface, RESTful API, and last one is the command line. Yes, now we'll be entering into the Google Cloud platform. Once we enter into that Google Cloud platform, so we have hamburger icon, it will be there. There we can move into the big data. There we have a BigQuery option. If you're clicking here, it's ready to use the Google BigQuery. No need to set up anything. Now, while we are entering to the Google BigQuery environment, so we have in the left-hand side, query history, saved queries, job history, transfers, that kind of the options, it will be there. We'll be seeing what is that. So query history. So query histories mean, so whatever the queries we used in the BigQuery, it will be showing like this. These are the queries we used in the previously. And saved queries. If you want to save the queries for your future purpose in the personal level or project level, we can save there. It will be visible here. What is the meaning of the job history? So job history is nothing but whatever the jobs we have created and load the data. So it will be showing like this. It got been failed or it got been uploaded the data in the successful. It will be showing that. So we can see that kind of the information on the fly with the help of these options. So that is the reason they have provided this kind of the option. And if you want to create a data sets and tables in the BigQuery level, so we can click on the go to classic UI, classic user interface. If you are clicking this particular button, we are able to get this kind of the environment. Here we can create the data set first, then under the data set we can create the table. So now, so I'll be going to create one data set. These are the public data sets are available. If you want to access this BigQuery and if you want to do some kind of the analysis, you can use the public data sets. So Google's BigQuery, Google is offering this kind of the data sets. So if you want to analyze the data, you can use this public data sets. So if you want to create in the project level, so we can create the data sets here. So whatever the project we have created in the Google Cloud platform, it will be showing here. So now I want to create a own data set. So whenever I click the particular data set option, it will be asking the data set ID. So simply I am creating one sample data set. That is my data set name. And so it is asking the location where you want to store this particular data set. It will be giving that some kind of the options. So we have to specify the US or UU or Asia Northeast. So just I am specifying the US and the data expiration. What is the meaning of the data expiration? So by default, it has a never radio button. And if you want to expire this particular data set, we have to specify the days. For example, if you want to expire this data set without our involvement, we can specify the dates. After 12 days, it will be expired. If you are not specifying, if you are choosing the never option, means it won't be expired. So until unless, we have to delete it. Then I am clicking the OK. Now it has been created the new data set in my second project. It's very simple. Once again, I am telling. So we have to choose the create new data set. Then it will be showing one window. We have to specify the data set ID. That is nothing but data set name and where we want to store the data set. And if you want to specify it has to expire, then we have to give the days. Otherwise, we can choose the never option. Yes, the data set has been created. Means with this option never, and data set location is US, and I have given the name as a sample. Now I want to create the table in this particular data set. So once I opt for this particular icon, so can you please observe here, create a new table. Okay, so this is the window it will be showing. So source is create from the source or create an empty table. So this is the option for create an empty table, create from the source. If you want to create from the source, we have to give this kind of information where the source is available and which format it will be available, CSV. And BigQuery is supporting CSV, JSON, new line delimited, AVRBO, Parquet, ORC. So far they have enabled for this kind of the file formats. And if you want to create from the empty table, it will be asking like this. Now I want to choose the first one, that is called the create from source. So I want to give where my source is available. That is the reason I want to upload my file, and I can upload the files from the Google Cloud Storage, Google Drive and Google Cloud BigTable. So this is a simple question. They will be asking in the certification level. So what is the sources of the BigQuery table? So it will be a file upload and Google Cloud Storage. Whatever the data is available in the Google Cloud Storage, we can pick it from there. And Google Drives, Google's own Drives concept is there. So Google Drives also, we can get the data from there. And Google Cloud BigTable. Now they have enabled the option for Google BigTable also. So these are the sources we can get it from the files. One more time I'm telling, file upload, Google Cloud Storage, Google Drive, Google Cloud BigTable. If I'm selecting the file upload, we have to give the path of the file. Just I am giving this. This is my file up. So now I have taken one file from my local disk. So now that file format is a CSV. And this is the source information. So once the source has been, the information has been given, then we have to give the destination table name. So sample is my data set name and I have to specify the destination table name. Now I am giving the baby names, obviously. So this here we have an option is there, table ID may contain the letters or numbers or underscores. So this is the example they have given. If you want to specify the table name like this, we can give it. This is the naming convention for table name. And schema, if you are comfortable, then you can choose the automatically detect. Otherwise you can give the what kind of the information is there, what is the column names we have to specify. We can give the column names here. So mine, my column name, so name, there is a string, and gender, there is also string, and So we have count, that is the integer value. So these are the three columns it will be there in my table, that particular file. So that is the reason I have given this information. And we have some kind of options also, it will be there. Those are the failed delimiters, so it will be supporting the comma. And if the file contains the tab kind of a delimiter or pipe, we can opt for this particular radio button. Others, we can specify what kind of a delimiter we have. Now, so if you want to skip the headers, so we have to specify that kind of information, and simply I'm creating the table. Can you please observe here, it will be showing that my table has been created. So with the name baby names, just I am clicking there, so it will be showing the table details. The table contains three columns. One is the name column, and another one is the gender, and another one is the count. So this is the table structure. So and the it's a metadata, in our terminology we'll be calling as a metadata. I want to see what kind of a data it will be there by pressing the preview option. Yeah, wonderful. Now I'm able to see the whatever the table has been loaded in my baby names. If you want to query the table, just click on the query table. So I want to see, select star from, this is the project name, second project, and this is the sample is my data set name, and baby names are nothing but my table name. So I want to limit to only 10 records, and I want to see this table information. So can you please observe here, it will be showing only the 10 records. These are the recording. So if you want to download this information, you can click on the download as CSV. If you want to download this in the form of the JSON, you can, or if you want to save as a table, you can press this particular option, and you can save to the Google Sheets. Thank you guys. Thank you.